Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can use sequence input stream in Java. Before starting, you can subscribe my YouTube channel by clicking on the link which is available at bottom right corner of this video. You can download my app TechMS that is available on Google Play. You can connect with me by following these details which are available in front of you. Now coming on to the topic. In this demonstration, I will be explaining the use of sequence input stream class. So I have imported java.io package. I have used asterisk sign. So it will import all the necessary classes which are available in this package. If you want to specify specific classes, then you can remove this statement and you can press Ctrl plus Shift plus O. This is a feature of Eclipse software that I am using. So if you press Ctrl plus Shift plus O, then required classes will be automatically imported. So either you can use java.io.asterisk for importing all the classes, or you can type Ctrl plus Shift plus O so that all necessary classes will be imported automatically. So here four classes are imported. Then user defined class name is sequence demo, which is containing main method. Inside main method, various statements are written and you can see main is throwing an exception, IO exception. Here throws clause is available. It means if any exception is available in main method, main will not be handling or catching that exception. It will be handled by the JVM, because main is called by JVM, Java Virtual Machine. So that's why throws clause is available here. Then file input stream FIS1 object is created, which is linked with file1.txt. It will open this file in read mode. Then FIS2 object is created, which is linked with file2.txt. It is opening file in read mode. For these two objects, these two files must be available in the system. Then sequence input stream SIS object is created, which is receiving two arguments, FIS1 and FIS2. So sequence input streams object combines more than one files together so that you can read input from those files in a single loop. If you want to read multiple files, then you have to process more than one loops. But if you want to place a single loop to read more than one files, then you can apply a sequence input stream class for that purpose. So here FIS1 and FIS2 both are linked with sequence input stream object SIS. So instead of FIS1 and FIS2, you can simply use SIS object. Then I want to store output of file1 and file2 into file3. So file output stream object FOS is created, which is linked with file3.txt. If this file is not available, it will be created automatically. And this is opening file3.txt in write mode. It means if it is available and it is containing some text, that text will be automatically removed. Then int ch, ch variable is declared, which is of integer type. Then a loop is available, which is reading content with the help of read method. Here sis.read is used. So a single content or single value will be read inside ch variable. Then that value will be type converted or type casted into character. And then with the help of write method, it is written inside FOS. So sis is sequence input stream object, which is linked with FIS1 or FIS2. So first it will read the data of file1.txt. Those data will be stored inside FOS, which is linked with file3.txt. Then after completion of file1, file2 will be read automatically with the help of this sis.read. So sequence input stream automatically reads values of multiple files which are linked with its object. -1 is representing end of file. So whenever end of file is available, this loop will be terminated and control will be transferred to these statements. These statements are closing all the objects which I have created, SIS, FIS1, FIS2 and FOS. So they are closed So this is the explanation of the program. Now we have to check whether these two files, file 1 and file 2, are available or not. So I have created this .java file in Sanjay project, and this project of Eclipse is stored in a particular path, which is D, then practice folder. Inside practice folder, you can see Sanjay project is available. Inside this project, file 1 and file 2.txt are available. File 1 is containing Sanjay and file 2 is containing Gupta. Now I want to combine content of these two files into third file using sequence input stream. So now I am going to execute this code. So I'm clicking on this button, which is for execution. It will not show any output on console because I have not used system.out.println, but it will create third file, that is file.txt. You can see it is created here. Now I am opening this file. You can see Sanjay Gupta, both the contents which are available in file 1 and file 2 are available in file 3 with the help of sequence input stream. So if you want to concatenate contents of more than one files, or you want to process contents of more than one files, then you can link those files with sequence input stream object, and then you can process all the files in a single rotation. So I hope you have understood this concept of sequence input stream. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video.